Welcome to Tech Syllabytes, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and viewer Nick Hansen posted a great question up on Facebook. Have you talked about Bittorrent Sync on your show? I find it beneficial, but would like to know, can it be made portable and the pros and cons of using it from a thumb drive? Oh my goodness, I love Bittorrent Sync. We've talked about it a bunch over the last year on TechZilla, and making it portable would be really cool. But first, let me catch everybody up on what Bittorrent Sync is. It's about unlimited peer-to-peer file syncing. Think of it as a DIY Dropbox that you own. There's no cloud storage that somebody else controls. All your data is stored on hard drives, on your computers and mobile devices. You update your homework with a big spreadsheet or a bunch of music in one folder, and Sync, derp, syncs it across all of your other machines. You can do that for all of your Sync content, individual Sync folders. For example, my Android device right here is syncing up to a music folder on my hard drive on my machine at home. It's really awesome. It's also 128-bit encrypted while it's in transit between your Sync installs, and it's really cool. The encryption means you can do things like share your secret or key with other people to create shared folders for groups, read-only folders, or a one-time secret that allows, well, you know, people to use it one time. It's really, really cool. Did I mention that? So yeah, if you drop or change or update something in a Sync folder, it's updated across all of your Sync installs on that folder. And you can store as much stuff as you have the drive space for with no monthly fees. Though, hey, several terabytes of music is gonna take a long time to transfer over the internet. You might wanna do that locally over the gigabit Ethernet or the Wi-Fi before you move that machine over to Uncle Rob's house. You gotta love offsite storage, and Sync makes it easy to have data here in your house and data there somewhere else. So if your house burns down or gets eaten by an earthquake, you still have your data. Sync is also free, as in beer, from BitTorrent. It runs on Windows, Mac OS X, Android, iOS, Windows Phone, the Kindle Fire, Linux, FreeBSD. People have Sync running on Raspberry Pis and NAS boxes. Technically, it's in beta, but we've been using it for over a year with no problems. I mean, think about it. Gmail was in beta for what, 7 years before they made it final? Sync works, it's private and it's free, and your files are encrypted while they're passing between machines on the internet, which reminds me of an awesome audiobook, Cryptonomicon. You can get it for free from our sponsor, audiblepodcast.com/techzilla. It's an incredible story of World War II, modern day digital currencies, and yeah, it makes encryption seem pretty freaking cool, which brings us back to Nick and portable apps, which are really freaking cool. If you've never been to portableapps.com, you essentially carry your favorite apps on a thumb drive or a cloud drive, and you can use it on PCs by just plugging it in. I can think of one major pro for BitTorrent Sync made portable: all your files from your other machines would sync up on your thumb drive, the one that you keep in your pocket, at least if it was big enough, and all those files would be on the thumb drive if you didn't have internet access. The con is that if you don't password protect or encrypt that thumb drive, anybody who finds it is gonna get all of your files. So yeah, that. The only other big problem in the portable app version of Sync is that it's still in development. Development is moving forward. Case in point, there was a dev trial version released in early June. It just isn't working now in early July. Hey, developing software takes time. So right now, we can't run Sync in a portable app mode, but at least you can use Sync across Windows, Mac OS X, Android, iOS, Windows Phone, the Kindle Fire, Linux, FreeBSD, and more. And that's good, that's right now. Hey, wanna build your own pirate box or free NAS? You can check out the videos on Die Tryin'. Please comment down below, tweet at TechZilla, post on Facebook.com/TechZilla, or hey, just share this video with a friend. I'm Patrick Norton, and thank you for watching this episode of TechZilla Bytes.